morning, students. Children, as you know that on 15th of August 1947, we became independent. We became free from the British rule. And it was decided, of course it was decided before we became independent, that the country should be governed by a constitution. Each country, they have a constitution by which a country is governed. I am talking about the democratic countries. So it was decided that the constitution should be written, and a committee of members were, they were elected, and they set to write the constitution, the rule book of our country. And it was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar who was the head of this committee. There were other members, two children, and there were seven members. Chairman was B.R. Ambedkar. Other members are Gopal Swami Iyengar, Aladi Krishna Swami Iyer, K.M. Munshi, Sayed Muhammad Sadullah, Sri N. Madhava Rao, and T.T. Krishnamacharya. Okay, so these members, they wrote this constitution. And children, as I discussed in the previous module, that it took some time to complete this book, the rule book, according to which our country is governed. And children, it was on 26th of November that finally it was completed and it was decided to be adopted. And after 2 months, that is 26th of January 1950, it was put into effect, means came into force. We started governing our country according to the constitution. So that's why we celebrate 26th of January as our Republic Day and 26th of November as our Constitution Day. In our school also we celebrate Constitution Day as well as the Republic Day. Let us know some more facts about our constitution. Children, the constitution was adopted on November 26, 1949. While it came into force, since we started governing our country with the help of constitution from 26 January 1950. Okay, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is regarded as the chief architect of the Indian constitution. As I told you, he is the one who was the chairman of this this constitution, means the committee which wrote the constitution, and he is known as the father of the Indian constitution. Okay, the constitution was handwritten. Just imagine, it was not typed, it was not printed, it's handwritten. Each and every page was handwritten one, and to calligraph and beautifully painted. Each and every page was painted. Okay, and this art with different Shantiniketan art in both English and in it is, I think, the only constitution which was written in two languages, in Hindi as well as English. Okay, the original copies of the constitution are kept in the library of the parliament. It is kept in the parliament helium library. Children, it is in the special helium file cases in the library of the parliament of India. Okay, and children, as you, I have shown you the constitution of India, the rule book. He is Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, the chief architect of this of our constitution. He is known as the father of the nation, children. And other facts, right, Indian constitution is one of the longest constitutions in the world. And Indian constitution is the only constitution that was written in two languages, English and Hindi. The constitution of India declared the country as a sovereign, socialist, secular and democratic republic. Now, republic, children, means a state in which the supreme power lies in the hands of the people, People only choose their representative. So it was that's why we call it our republic. Okay, it took nearly 2 years, 11 months and 18 days to finish the constitution of India. So you can understand such a long time it took, because it is one of the longest written constitutions of India. Okay, so it's a thing. These are the things to be remembered, the key features of our constitution. And remember, Mahatma Gandhi, in the year 1922, he wanted that India should have its own constitution, and it was on 16th of May 1946, before India became independent, cabinet mission made a declaration that a constitution should be written. Okay, and that's how the 13 committees were appointed by the constitution, and rough draft was prepared by first B.N. Rao. Okay, and afterwards the constituent assembly committee formed with B.R. Ambedkar as the chairman, and then the constitution was adopted on 26th of November with 284 members appended the signature out of 290. Okay, and in this way our constitution came into effect. Thank you, Chief.